All right, so we were going to start the factors which are affecting the NDB and ADF. Before that, we have already discussed the principle of operations. We have discussed how this is formed and what are the requirements. Now we are left with just the accuracy. Now the accuracy depends on the errors, and what the errors are caused will indirectly depend on the accuracy. So first error or first thing which directly affects the accuracy is static interference. Now, this is not your static pressure. This is the static which is present in the lighting, in the electric phenomena happening in the nature. For example, this. Okay. So now the precipitation static due to collision of the particles of the waters and the ice crystals, they can affect the RMI or RPI. Now, RPI, I've already told you, it is relative bearing indicator. Okay. Whereas the RMI is what? It's the radio magnetic indicator. Don't be confused by these two terms. They mean the same thing, except for the fact this is magnetic indicator. This is the relative bearing indicator. We'll see the questions and try to solve them accordingly. Right now, what is modeled is static interference. Secondly, thunderstorm itself. Whenever the thunderstorm is, right now in Delhi, it's about to rain. So we're having thunderstorms. So we'll have a lot of static electricity discharges present. These discharges cause the bearing errors in the ADF. During CP activity, the only sensible use of ADF is to indicate where the active cells are. So in our in our ancient times in aviation, let's say in 2000s and all, when we did not have those airborne radar systems, we could have used to detect the CB. Okay, CB is a type of a cloud. And in order to detect a CB, we could have ADF indications. If we were having Iranius indications, that means the CB is just around us. Second is the night effect itself. The night effect is very important for us. I've already explained some of the night effect in our previous chapter, but here we'll have in deep. Due to the presence of sky waves during night, okay, sky waves interfere with the loop area and cause it to hunt. As the sky wave is constantly changing, right, sky waves change with the night, okay, night, the layer drops, remember. This causes error up to 30 degrees, this is degrees, okay, which are maximum during dusk and dawn. They can be observed at a distance greater than 70 nautical mile from the beacon. So basically, you can see in this diagram, the ionospheric region in the night changes because of the because the radiation is not present. That is, the sun has stopped its radiation. So the ionospheric region changes, and hence the range increases or reduces in the day. This is known as night effect, and that will directly affect the accuracy of ADF. These can be reduced by using the beacon closer to the aircraft. That means if the NDB is closer to the ADF, using a beacon with lower frequency. So if the frequency is lower, the range will reduce, and that will hit the aircraft perfectly. So because if the range, see, if the frequency is high, what will happen is the dead space. Remember the dead space? We will have aircraft here, which will result to no signals. Instead of this, we want the frequency to reduce, so the frequency will directly hit the aircraft. Use beacon with greater output. If we have a greater power output, then we can assume that the frequency will actually go through the ionospheric region and not collapse or dissipate. Avoid using the equipment within 1 hour of the sunrise and sunset. Now, why is this important? Because this is the time when we have twilight and all. We'll explain you twilight. Already explained you twilight, I remember. So Rupesh does not have twilight. Twilight is the period which is dusk and dawn, before dusk and before dawn. So basically, before sunrise, there's a period where you will already be seeing the sun rays, okay? And secondly, after the sunset, even the sun has set, we still see the sun rays because of the phenomena called twilight. That is because of the diffraction of the earth. All right, these are the reasons. So important, what is important here is the night effect. A night effect happens because of the ionospheric layer change. Then we have the coastal refraction. Now, coastal refraction, it's because the density of water and air is different. Okay, so it will directly affect the radio wave. Radio waves speed up over water. The velocity of the radio wave increases over water, whereas on the land it is less. So what happens is this. Okay, speeding up of the wave causes the front to bend or refract away from its normal path and pull it towards the coast. What is happening in this picture? This is the NDB. This is the aircraft. So aircraft has the ADF. Now see what happens. Okay. The wave which was suppose if suppose this is the wave which was sent, it was supposed to go this way, but it has refracted, so it is coming towards the aircraft. So it will give you a false reading. The aircraft will think that the NDB is somewhere here, where it is not. Okay, this is called coastal refraction, and this is the least at 90 degrees perpendicular to the coast. So if you are 90 degrees perpendicular to the coast, you can see that the coastal refraction reduces and it becomes nil. The effect can be minimized, as I told you, using signals that cross the coast at 90 degree. Flying higher, when you fly higher, you can expect that the water will not affect the radio wave propagation. Using NDBs on or near the coast, when you have the NDB closer, you can assume that error to be smaller, right? So the error will be smaller, whereas here the error is big. See how much big the error is, right? So this is the coastal refraction. This is the picture you can see. So by now the aircraft thought that this is here, but then when he came over the land, he realized or she realized that, oh, the NDB is here. Okay. This is known as coastal refraction. Mountain effect. Mountainous areas can also have deflections. Now, when you talk about mountains and we have a NDB, okay, this is an NDB. What happens is deflection. Okay, reflection happens. Then this could cause fading. This can also be causing fading, and this will give you errors. The error will increase at low altitude and can be minimized by flying higher. Okay. And station interference. Now, station interference is because of the congestion of stations nearby. Suppose Delhi and nearby, let's say Gurgaon, and Noida is also opening up its own. So let's say if these three airports are operational and they all have the NDB, their ranges are high because they are using LF and MF band. So what happens is congestion takes place. There is station interference will take place. The aircraft can be confused which NDB is giving signal to it. Yes, the frequency is set, but it is after all, this is radio waves. So might be that the radio waves itself try to cancel. It is known as fruiting also. We'll study this in... Okay, we'll study this in BOR, but I will be telling you this is known as fruiting also. Okay, this will cause bearing errors. By day, the use of NDB within the DOC. Now, if you remember DOC, I taught you it is designated operational coverage, right? Basically, what the book tells you the limits of the particular facility. Okay, coverage. Will not be afford protection from interference by day. Okay, by night be aware. This is the trick you can always remember. Okay, due to the night effect, the range will increase. So of course, let's say every particular NDB had a DOC. Okay, all the NDBs have DOC, but by night what happens? All of their range increases. So now they are affecting each other. Okay. Factors affecting, if you always want to read this, let me know. I'll pause and you can read. Okay. If you're not saying anything, that means that you don't have doubt. That's what I'm imagining. Please let me know. Okay.
Yes, I'm reading.
Okay. Let me know if you want me to pause. Okay. The other factors are quadrantal error. Now you see this picture. This is known as quadrantal error. What is this? This occurs because parts of the aircraft which reflects and re-radiate the signal itself. We don't require mountains, we don't require land. What happens is, because of the aircraft's own structure, the radio waves could reflect. You can see here, right? Radio wave is coming in this section and it reflects due to the fuselage and it goes back. Not only this, you can see all the others also. So this is known as quadrantal error. Error is maximum when coming 45 degrees to the fuselage. This is a really important error because, see, we all will not be seeing these errors and noting down as a pilot, but for the exam purposes, you need to remember these errors. Okay. And these errors are why? These are errors because on your fuselage and your aircraft, you already have a lot of electrical structures present. You have electrical facilities and electrical systems available. So these errors, these radio waves are interfered. Radio waves, after all, are what? They are produced because of current being flown, right? When you already have electrical system on board, it will interfere. The maximum refraction occurs in the quadrants, which are these 045, 135, 225, 315. These are all at an interval of 90 degrees and all are at 045, this. Okay, sorry. 045, 135, 225, 315. All are at 45 degrees. Turning aircraft will suffer more of this error. Why? Because if you turn the aircraft, the chances of your reflection increase. And lastly, we'll explore with angle of bank, lack of failure warning system. Now, angle of bank, okay, we understand that because angle of bank is changing, the ADF might be somewhere, which is when you're putting an angle of bank, the ADF is not hitting that area. The NDB's signal are not hitting that ADF area. We understand that. Now, what is lack of failure warning system? This is very important. And this is where the DGC asks you the question. Lack of failure warning system basically is that even if the radio wave are not being transmitted correctly from the NDB, or there is an error in the ADF itself, the ADF will not tell the pilot that it is having wrong signals. The pilot will keep on seeing the ADF and go wrong. This is the worst error in the whole of the NDB and ADF, you'll find that. Okay. What are the factors which affect the range? Till now we decided the accuracy. Now we decide range. First of all, transmission power. This is also known as inverse square law. Basically, P is directly proportional to R square. Frequency. The lower the frequency, lesser the attenuation, greater the ground wave range. Remember, we're not talking about the sky waves. In the sky waves, it's opposite. Type of terrain, longer range over water. This is the formula I've already told you in the second chapter, radio propagation. And this is where everything comes to point. See, I told you, I will explain you everything. Protection range. Now, this is same as DOC. Within the promulgated protection range, you get the required field strength of wanted to unwanted signal in the ratio of this. So it's just like a DOC, it's about the protection range. But this is only during the day. Protection ranges are not valid due to the night effect. I've already explained you night effect. Now type of emission. So I've already explained this part. N0N A1A has more range than N0N A2A because this is non-modulated. Okay. Now let's discuss the numerical application of the NDB. The DGC has also been asking a lot of questions related to the application of NDB. What are the types of questions it could be asking? Okay, so we will look at those perspective. Of course, as a pilot, this is where you will actually play the role. The questions which are being asked are, draw the relative bearing. Means with the diagram or with the things which will be given in the question, you will have to find out the relative bearing of the aircraft. Second is finding out the QDM or the bearing. Okay. Third is dot pi dg angle. Now this is not required. Okay. This is actually 1:60 rule. Okay. I'll explain your page what is 1:60 rule, but you guys know what is a 1:60 rule. Time to station. Okay. Time to station is also 1:60 rule. Intercept. Now this is important, but this is 80 pages. Okay, interception is basically it could be also asked. I will do these questions also. These are present in Keith Williams. Okay, interception is basically if an aircraft is following this line, let's say from A point to B point, they'll ask you at what bearing does Lucknow lie. Okay, so they will say that at 1100 Zulu, Lucknow was at this bearing, let's say. The bearing with respect to this is what this, right? So they'll say what is the range of Lucknow. What these all questions are related to interception. Okay, now interception will also be taught to you in your MCC, which is multi crew and coordination, if your flying clubs have those. This is the drawing RB. I told you that there are questions related to the relative bearing. So you can see the NDB is here. This is the aircraft, so ADF will be on the aircraft. Now, if we have to calculate the relative bearing, how will you calculate this? This is what? This is the heading. This is the magnetic heading. So if you draw, let's say, this is my north. Okay. So you can see that this is 060. You can see this is what? This is the QDM. So my relative bearing with respect to this is 020 in this case. My bearing of NDB is 080. Okay. This is the types of question they can ask you. This is the bearing, this is the relative bearing, and this is the heading. Another question is, see, this aircraft is turning. So its heading is 108. So if I were to draw the straight line, same straight line, dropping here, this is my north. Okay. This is my line. So you can see that my heading is this. Heading is 108. Okay. Now remember, questions will not give you pictures. So this is just your easy parts. It's just to help you imagine. This is my heading. I've already told you the bearing is what? The bearing is this. Bearing means the NDB is bearing. So it would be, I don't know, anything. We have to calculate that, let's say. Now, what is relative bearing of the NDB? Clockwise from the heading, clockwise from the nose. This is clockwise. Okay. So here it is given 332. 332 is the relative bearing. Okay. RB plus minus heading gives you the bearing or QDM in this case. So relative bearing is given 108 plus minus the heading. Now heading is given 332. Heading is given 108. Relative bearing is given 332. Now how to put that bearing and calculate this? Does anyone have any idea? I've just explained you this. This first portion might be. Can we directly add? Then? Yeah. We'll get the answer. Go ahead. Now you're getting to the point. What is the answer then? Okay, this part is 28 degrees, correct? Okay, because if you have 360, this is 28. Now, if you subtract 108 from 28, you subtract 28. Okay, you get what? 080. Okay, so this is the same aircraft. If its heading is 060, see the QDM is 080. In this case also, QDM is 080. The bearing changes. The relative bearing has changed. Okay. So this is the relative bearing. All right. The second type of question, same type of question, but here what we're doing is, you can see. Yeah, so this is the heading. Okay. You can see the diagram and you realize that, see, the aircraft is on this particular. So whatever is bearing is of the NDB, this is on which the aircraft is. Okay. I'm just trying to make you visualize all this, okay? So that once you try to do the questions in the Oxford as well as somewhere, you will be able to do that, okay?